Last session, you all went to bed with varying success. Fugio had a dream about a calm field that turned into a storm where he tried to reach a jade figure in the ocean before waking up. They all conferred with Hallis and decided to go to Moonbright. Hallis gave the 50 gold up front with 100 shared for travel and 4 scrolls of sending to contact him along the way. The group set out to buy 2 horses and a cart, and after cheating Mr. Magoo with painted gold coins and doing some pretty prim haggling with a starving Victorian boy, they went on their way. The party was also introduced to some of Marble's Clef's religions, which includes a fairly new practice called the Annex Divinity. Then they left town, set up camp, and Zenovar saw a creepy fucking tree with a creepy cat and got an evil apple out of it.
I bet that's never gonna bite us also. I bet yeah. We're never going to face consequences for anything ever.
He wanted to see if it would lead him somewhere. I don't know.
And it did. It led him into the apple dimension.
Then you all met a kink archaeologist, and Elo took a bone from him while lying about getting him a grant. Dante passed out while smoking and almost lit the campsite on fire, and Gash refused to go to sleep so she could stay on watch passive-aggressively.
Yeah. You're welcome.
And that was the end of the last session. You guys all got your new levels. Can everybody tell me what their subclasses were? Or anything neat that you're interested about the new class that you got? I guess we'll start with Gash, because Gash is still awake.
Okay. As Gash, I guess, gains her level while just blinking in exhaustion as, like, the sun rises, a little text box appears over her head. Achievement, get Path of the Juggernaut. So she is going on the Path of the Juggernaut, which is, now that she's third level, she gets Thunderous Blows, which means your rage instills you with the strength to batter around your foes, making any battlefield your domain. Once per turn while raging, when you damage a creature with a melee attack, you can force the target to make a strength saving throw, and on a failure, I push the target 5 feet away from me, and I can choose to immediately move 5 feet into the target's previous position, so I can push him. Yeah. Gash is so angry while sitting awake this entire night that she comes up with that.
Like, the resolution of staying up all night both makes you exhausted, but also makes you realize that, like, you are the only one capable of, like, standing resolute where you are. The rest of these chuckle fucks are like...
I'm surrounded by twinks.
You're surrounded by twinks. You are the only one with any kind of grit or virilitude to you. You
except level maybe up because you get frustrated.
Yeah, yeah. And there's a certain amount of, like, groundedness that you need for what you're capable of, and Elo will never have that. He is slime. I'm gonna roll to see who wakes up first. Fugio, what kind of new shit did you get?
Oh, so, I guess somehow I got an epiphany, and now I'm learning the open hand technique, or the way of the open hand. Maybe it came to me in a vision, like most things seem to. Let's see. With my new technique, I can make people prone when I attack them, and stuff like that, which is pretty fun. I can also deflect missiles now, so that's
wow.
Wow. Well, I just love the idea of, like, a nuclear missile coming in and Fugio's like, I got this, and just, like, bats it away.
Yeah,
he, like, limp, it's like a limp wrist kind of motion. It's like, what's this? Skadoosh.
There is a squirrel that has been dropping shit on you for the past hour.
Oh my god.
It's really frustrating because you're so tired. It was such a late night. You got woken up so suddenly and you just want to sleep in for once despite being a monk. This fucking squirrel. And eventually you catch one of the acorns that is, like, dropping from its fucking branch and you just chuck it back at the squirrel and the squirrel falls off the branch and lands on the ground.
What an asshole monk, dude.
He's like, he does this is for a moment that immediately, like, it hits him and he's just like, oh my god, I just heard a squirrel.
What have I done? I've learned powers, but at what cost?
At what cost?
Maybe it was an evil apple squirrel.
Oh, evil squirrel.
It's an apple squirrel from the
evil
apple
dimension. Oh, yeah. The fucked up apple dimension. You know what? Whatever Fugio can say in his mind to justify his action, he will do. So
we're going down a dark path.
Okay, the next person to wake up is Dante. Did Dante get any cool shit?
He got 3 more spells.
Wow!
Wow, isn't it fun?
Hey, out of curiosity's sake, can any of them put out fires?
No, I got Maximilian's Earthen Grasp, Shadow Blade, because I thought that was edgy, and Suffer. It says, you point at a creature within range and speak a terrible word, commanding them to suffer. The target must make a charisma saving throw. If they fail, they take 2d8 necrotic damage and 2d8 psychic damage, and they have disadvantage on strength and dexterity ability checks for 1 minute.
Dante has learned slurs.
He has.
He went to bed dreaming about violence, very tired from the night before, and the cigarette butt turned into a fucking hilt. There you go. Wow.
I guess it was worth setting the forest on fire after all.
Last two, let's do a little dude. Hell yeah, hell yeah.
B-low.
Okay.
What if he got nothing?
Yeah, just fuck you.
Fuck you.
I got detect magic, and... Lesser Restoration.
Oh, you took the College of Lore, right?
College of Lore.
Okay. The guilt from the past couple of days has really been eating at you. Like, you remember your dad, and you remember what your dad has, like, always told you about, like, what's right, how you're supposed to go about the world, like, you're supposed to treat other people with, like, respect and kindness and all that. And I don't know, something about that, like, it brings you back to, like, all the stories your dad would tell you about, like, you know... all of these like, wonderful people who used to do good deeds and, like, go around the countryside helping out others for nothing but, like, for the goodness of being good.
Right.
And you feel that kind of sour in the back of your throat because, you know, they never had ending. You never got to get to the part where it was the end of the line and the experience was over. Yeah. Like, they just went off to the sunset. And there's something about that doesn't sit right with you. So you end up just thinking about your dad for a while in the morning. Ain't that just the way? The last person to wake up is Elo.
Hooray, lazy ass.
Hey.
All you do is fucking sleep.
Fuck you.
This really sad and somber moment, and then Elo is just, what the fuck is up?
Yay! Elo is now officially an arcane trickster.
Yay!
Warm rope can get their fine-honed skills of stealth and agility with magic. Learning tricks of enchantment and illusion. These rogues include pickpockets, burglars, but also pranksters, mischief makers, and a significant number of adventurers. So I can cast magic now, and also my mage hand is very powerful.
I'm gonna say, like, the equivalent of turning off an alarm clock. Like, Xanabar gets awake and just kind of, like, you know, is trying to get his shit together, kind of, like, being reasonably... talkative as it happens, just as Xanabar is, and literally, like, you're slapping an alarm clock to continue sleeping, your mage hand just comes out and just baps him in the face.
Oh shit.
Xanabar is dead.
But I also took douse, so if we ever actually have a forest fire, I can help with that.
I'll just start starting him. I'll start him, you end him. That's good.
But I also took Identify, so...
That's a good one.
I'm very good at dealing with magical shit, magical items now.
Great. Now you guys are all up, and most of you are kind of rested. Not well rested, just you slept. It was fine. Gash didn't. It was less fine.
Oh, sleepy time.
You just see this lump of cow sitting outside.
I love how big she is.
It's very big. She has to make up for all of you fucks.
So the day is overcast. It's not as sunny as it was the previous days. Like, the wind is kind of picking up along the crevasse. But it's, like, going, like, across the crevasse towards you guys, not pushing you in, so it's fine. But it still makes the day a lot colder than it's previously been.
Mmm.
Great. Does somebody want to roll a d10 for me?
No.
Oh,
I'll roll the d10.
I forgot to get my dice thing up.
The first part of your day of travel is relatively calm. Well, as calm as it can be when all of you guys are fucking sleep deprived. and it's the same stretch of land you've been on for the same 3 days. A lot of you are exhausted. Many of you are irritated. Probably primarily at Dante for setting shit on fire and waking you guys all up.
Listen, can a man apologize and just be done with it?
No, but he's not. Everybody just likes that.
Who's driving the cart today?
Not Elo.
Gash should not.
The animals are scared of us anyway, so.
Yeah, the animals hate us. Animals.
You and I can snooze.
Alright, so that just leaves the rest of us.
Yeah, so Xanabar, Fujio, and Dante.
Is everybody going to be too mad at me to let me drive?
Huh? Probably.
Ela won't. Ela will be fine with it.
Okay, so I guess Dante's sitting in the back with Gash and Elo.
He's reading the very hungry caterpillar.
Gash might sleep, because now we're no longer at watch, so it's time to pass out. She's unhappy because she's not on a nice patch of grass to sleep.
Elo's gonna cuddle in somebody's lap.
It ain't gonna be mine.
Everybody uses Jahura as a pillow. They just sleep on her. They just sit on her tummy. She's car seat.
She would never let you do this, but it's so. But I wish.
It's a good mental image. For later.
Yeah. If Ela like awkwardly scooted up to like her back and like cuddled with that, she wouldn't brush him off. But last time he sat on top of her, she threw him like 30 feet.
Just gonna casually use Mage Hand to flip the pages of the Very Hungry Caterpillar.
He would read it aloud if you asked politely.
Fujio and Xanabar, could you make perception checks for me?
I got an 8.
Okay.
King of not seeing shit.
Xanabar? Oh, you got a 21. I see. Yeah. Okay. Fujio, straight up not paying attention to the road.
It's that phenomenon where you're like driving, but you don't remember, like you get to your destination and you don't remember the drive.
That's literally
dissociating at the wheel. Occasionally, Xanabar has to be like, no, there's a rock. So, you guys are just on your way. Throughout the day, it gets more and more like misty, like part of the wind is like picking up the river and like the steam of it is like pulling across the crevasse a little bit. Xanabar, with that 21, you see a slight movement ahead of you. It's so small. It's so unbelievably small. And it looks like it might be some sort of small animal?
Cat, maybe?
The closer maybe you get to it, it's not big enough to be a cat. At first, you might think it's like a weird bug. Something extremely small, but it is also moving at like a pretty reasonable pace for something that tiny. And it, like, you almost don't know what it is until it's like pretty much directly in front of the horses. It actually freaks out the horses so much that they stop and kind of kick up their hooves a bit. Xanabar, get a closer look. That is a severed human hand that is just walking.
Is that like all the Addams family?
Addams family? Really. So
the hand kind of like scuttles around the horse, trying to like get away from the hooves.
I feel like he'd probably just be like, "What the fuck? Can you like stop the carriage for a moment?" And just like want to check it out and be. I feel like he'd want to cast some detect magic. Like, is there like a sorcerer around anywhere?
Okay, great. So you cast detect magic.
Wow. When you say like stop the cart, it takes Fujio a second to process what you said.
The horses have already decided to stop the cart because they're freaked out by the.
Okay, so basically everybody in the back seat is getting launched forward.
Yeah, there's a slight kick.
Fujio is just playing Mario Kart and not realizing that his car has fallen off of the road.
The coconut mall theme is playing.
Oh, no. It's a detect magic, so it's like a radius. But the radius is like large enough that you can get the hand in there.
Oh, all right.
It's not magical, but if there was a magic to be associated with it, it would be necromancy. It's just a hand, and it's just scuttling around. It kind of, like, moves- it finally gets away from the freaked-out horses and kind of, like, moves off into, like, the grass, but it just kind of, like, stays there. Because it's still curious about what the fuck is happening.
Dante's a necromancer, send him in!
Yeah.
Get his old ass in there!
Getting him out of the car and, like, pushing him outside. Stumbles over.
You know about these things? There's a hand, severed hand there. Can't you do anything about it?
And he just looks at it, and then he just looks back at Xanabar, and he's like, okay. Alright.
They have, like, runs in a little circle on the ground.
Is it like still in the bushes?
Yeah, just like in the low grass that's like on the edge of the forest.
Okay. He's going to walk up to it a little cautiously, but he's like, "What the fuck?"
Gash will also get out and walk with him.
Ham stops.
Ela will get out too.
I hate to say it, but like the mental image that I'm getting almost kind of makes it seem kind of cute in the way that it's scuttling. If it's like fucking what's it called? The Addams Family.
Yeah, can I
want Dante to just like reach his hand out and go. Pss, 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 pss.
Wait, Dante does that?
Yeah, I want him to.
Okay, he's gonna do that. The hand is going to reach out like it is going to shake your hand, but it isn't gonna move at all. It's just holding your hand like it's about to.
Holy shit.
I wanna look at my hand. Is it, like, bloody? Is it cleanly severed?
It's a very clean hand. If you had to venture, it's like manicured, but like a week ago. You know what I mean?
Okay. If I could make a check on that, that'd be cool. So he's currently holding on to this hand, and he just rolled a 15.
Okay. You've seen things like this before. This is like a level 2, like a necromancer trick that people can do. It's literally like severing a hand and then reanimating it just to see if you have the potential to resurrect bodies.
Okay.
It is one of the easier things that I've
ever done. Yeah. I believe I had looked at all of them. I don't remember the name of it, but it was just like, okay, Lil Hand.
Lil Hand.
It's kind of cute. It sounds cute.
At this point, you can tell it's not actually attached to a necromancer, though, which is why it didn't really kick up when Xanapar cast Detect Magic on it.
It seems like it might be friendly.
Does he communicate any of this to us, or is he just like,
He's staring and, like, fucking rubbing his chin, like, okay.
When he doesn't say anything, uh-huh. Gash pokes, like, it, like, gently.
Ela's going to...
The hand jerks and starts climbing up Dante's arm, and then just kind of like sits on its shoulder.
Oh no! I'm gonna have to adopt it.
Ela's gonna make an attempt to absorb it into his gooey flesh and identify it.
Can he do that?
I can't. Well, maybe.
I feel like Dante's gonna grab it off his shoulder and like move it out of the way. What the fuck is wrong with you?
He won't even let Ela eat the hand.
He won't. He does not want to. He's holding it above him. Above your head.
I wasn't going to eat it.
You were just going to absorb it.
I feel like Zan would want to just set it down on the floor again and like slap it to see if it goes somewhere.
Why y'all want to hurt this fucking thing?
The hand overhears everyone having these conversations, and like as Dante is like holding it above his head, the hand like squirms out of his fingers and just kind of like plops on his head and then climbs down his back into his cloak.
Oh god.
Well, he lives there now, I guess.
Just make sure that you feed it.
Yeah. I mean, feed it what?
And
finger food. What else?
As for explanations, honestly, I don't think Dante has any. He's just looking at them like shrugs. I have no idea where this thing came from.
Yeah, Gash shrugs too.
He does find it very endearing, though.
Yeah, I don't look around and see.
Gross, but he's not creeped out by it.
Yeah, Gash seems indifferent. I would like to make it like a perception check to see where we are and if there are any other hands.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, I probably have. I think it's disadvantage on ability checks. Awesome, yep. Right? And that's a 2. So plus my perception, that's a 6.
Okay.
The other one was a 19.
Yeah, you're not fully here right now. The fact that there's a severed hand feels like not real. You're like half sure that you're still like napping. You maybe see like a spider and you're like, is that another one? And then you're like, nope, that's not even a real spider. That's a crack on the ground.
Okay, well that sure was fucking something.
Okay.
I guess, in character.
I guess we're loading back into the cart now.
With this hand?
Yeah,
the hand is like in his cloak just chilling.
when everybody stops talking about the hand does climb back up and just kind of like sit on Dante's shoulder again.
Oh my god.
It's like a little parrot.
It really is our pet now.
And he pulls out the very hungry caterpillar. So the horses have calmed down at this point.
Yeah.
So we can proceed.
Fujio managed to calm down the horses. It's fine.
God, at least he can do something, like, right?
Animal handling. Oh.
Do you want to roll animal handling so you can calm down the horses?
Oh, I was thinking I have animal handling.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
roll it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. Roll well, it. What if I get a bad roll?
Then you get a bad roll.
Then you get a bad roll.
Okay, I got a 17.
I rolled a 19, but I'm not helping y'all.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Where's my animal handling? Oh, it's minus one.
Yeah.
Oh, a 4.
Elo runs over to the horse and immediately gets fucking clocked.
There's just
the
like,
horse is still stamping like, by the time Elo tries to go help with the horses, and the horse like, just literally kicks him in the fucking face.
Like, he does that like tune thing where he like blows into his thumb and it like pops back into place.
Yeah.
All right, so we're back on the move.
Elo does not.
Hell yeah.
The horses now. Yeah. Elo's very dead set against these horses.
Added to backstory, grudge against horses.
Hates any horse.
Horse grudge.
Flip clop, motherfuckers, hell yeah. Get back on the road. And it's another long stretch before anything really happens. This is a very unpopulated, like, way to travel to the next city, and it's getting to the point where it's like, the fact that you saw a severed hand was interesting, but now you've had it for a few hours, the novelty is lost because you're tired and you've been traveling for a while. The hand is just kind of sitting on Dante.
Elo's just like, Dante, make it do a trick.
Dante's like, God damn it. I can't just read in peace.
The hand is like flipping pages for Dante now. It's like a whole fucking thing.
Is your severed hand gonna have like a name, or are we just calling it severed hand?
I think Dante's working on a name right now. I'm still coming up with it. Yeah.
Dante 2.
Names for your severed hand. Coolnames.com.
Elo's also gonna cast Mage Hand, but make it corporeal this time and like visible, and have it just sit on his shoulder.
The severed hand, attempts to, as soon as the severed hand sees you also with a hand on your shoulder, is like, what the fuck? Hell yeah! Another hand! And like climbs up to get on your other shoulder.
Just the stick bug dance.
I've decided on a new name for this hand.
Uh-huh.
His name is Dante Jr. Junior for short.
Aww. All right. So the path continues on for a little while. And it's the day is cold, so you can't even get a proper sleep in. Like, the wind keeps rustling through, like, the vague canopy that's in the back of the fucking cart. There's, like, this unsettling chill that just, like, comes over you. And through the entire day, you can't shake the feeling that this hand is from something else. And maybe where you're going isn't the best place to be going.
Isn't that great?
Isn't that great?
You ever get that realization?
The mist only gets worse, and it's getting harder and harder to see where the sun is in the sky.
Methinks we are lost.
This is a little spooky. Is it possible to make, like, a perception or investigation?
Yeah, check. If you want to make a perception.
Okay, let me do that real quick.
I'd like to make a nature check.
I rolled a 9.
It's hard to see that shit in front of you.
That's great.
Can I make a perception check? I would like to try. Oh, good. 8.
Yeah,
it's fucking misty, dude.
Yeah, I got a 3 plus 3 is a 6. So that's about the same like level
It's so fucking misty, dude.
Yeah.
It's so insane. Roll?
None of us can see shit.
But it's just like a question. Is it something similar to something I've experienced in like the wild or like...
Yeah, this is like a wild regularly occurring thing. It's just kind of off-putting.
You know, misty days just be like that.
Yeah, paired up with the hand, it's like, ooh, Silent Hill.
It's scary.
Which one of you is divorced? Why are we entering Silent Hill now?
How close are we to, like, our destination?
You're about 3 days in. It's gonna take 4 more days to get there. You're being a little bit more cautious as you move through the mist, just because, like, you're by a massive, like, 1,000-foot drop, and then on the other side is a bunch of, like, fucking roots and shit, and it'd be bad if you, broke a wheel on one of those little bitches. So it's a very precarious drive. And the rest of the day is just kind of, you know, unsettling. Everyone's a little bit anxious. It's not a good mood, not a good vibe.
It certainly makes for a hard time reading this fucking book.
It gets to the end of the day.
How long is the Very Hungry Caterpillar?
It's not long at all.
He's been like rereading it over again.
We need to get him another book.
Getting to the end of the day, the people who are driving, can you make perception checks for me again?
I got a 19 plus 2, so 21.
Oh, okay, really good.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so just barely on the horizon, you can see the sun is at its final moments. And as the haze of the day catches up with you all, you're each a little exhausted from the previous evening. Something catches your eye. Along the road, it's a jutting slab of wood, kind of rotted from, like, it's just been there for a while. And it strikes you as odd, but, like, not odd enough that you have to stop. It's just fucking wood. Mm-hmm. But as you continue, more and more of these markers appear.
Mm-hmm.
Until just ahead, the bleary gray mass of a structure appears. In the distance, a few more buildings seem clustered ahead of it. A town? The first thing you notice is the silence. Whistling through the wood and cracked stone, the wind has been your travel companion for the day and is attempting to alarm you of the upcoming emptiness. The slow, cautious movement of the cart becomes more and more difficult as the wooden slabs become clustered in larger amounts. Eventually, that first structure comes into view. It's a temple.
Mm.
And anyone who has proficiency in religion can roll a religion check to see what the temple is for.
Hey, your boy rolled a nat 20, so I got a 27. Oh, 27, baby!
Dante gets a vision from God.
He notices the shit that's coming up ahead. He notices the temple and whatever remains of the sunlight, like, coming through the stained glass that's definitely been broken. And it's a temple to the god Pelor, who's, Pelor. It's Pelor.
Pelor!
Where is the fucking scripture that I was thinking? The god Pelor, the sun father. He's a patron to farmers and a formerly popular religious figure. He's a part of the original creationist pantheon, which is, like, you know, most of the gods you hear about in D&D. So, like, fucking lots of them that I cannot remember right now. He's like a really big god. He's a pretty great dude. He's also, he fucking hates the undead. That's one of his big things.
That makes me angry. I'm a fucking necromancer. Do you keep forgetting that?
Necromancer, in fairness.
Here's the thing about it. You would be concerned, except half of the temple has fallen into the crevasse.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. So, on one side of it, there's a sprawling a graveyard.
Yes.
Just like going out on all sides, just these, like a mixture of like fancy tombs, wooden tombstones, and as you see them, it occurs to you what the wooden planks are supposed to represent now that the trail is like led up to all of this. And none of them were a part of the graveyard. These were just pieces of wood that were stuck up. It gets harder to navigate the closer you get, but eventually you get close enough to the temple and like the area around it that it becomes easier to see what's around all of you. So, as you kind of move in next to the cemetery, you go between the cemetery and like what appears to be a building. And it's a building that's, as you get closer to it, the front of it is singed. Like it's been burned, but it has not been burned down.
Are there, like, any people around? Like, any villagers? Or is this, like, a ghost town?
No. As you enter into the town, it is dead silent. The only thing you can hear is wind.
I just keep thinking about that one fucking image of, that My Little Pony character.
I was thinking the same
like,
image.
Something bad happened here! So this town looks like absolute dog shit, basically.
Here's
the funky cool thing about this town. It's fine. It's mostly fine. There are some buildings that have, like, scorch marks, especially in the area that you just entered. Like, the building beside you, the four buildings in front of you, they all have, like, a singe to them. But beyond, like, a single house and, like, some of the buildings that have fallen into the crevasse, these buildings are fine. A little old, perhaps. Like, a little antiquated, given, like, some of the newer building, like, techniques that have been come out with like the past like century or so, but these buildings are like, aside from being old and a little bit burnt up, they're fine.
Okay, how fucking weird.
Yeah.
So For some reason, the shit is a little busted and people are gone completely. It's not natural.
Gonna get out totally unperturbed and just look at, like, the houses and be like, well, this makes it easy to stay here for the night. And it's just gonna immediately go in, like, to one of the houses and just open the door.
Alright, so, for the most part, this isn't actually a residential area. Most of these places are shops.
Can we loot it? I wanna loot it.
Hey, can we loot it?
Yeah, that's what Ela's doing, getting money!
A good half of them have just, like, completely severed from, like, it looks like this town has been split in half by the crevasse.
Okay, that's fucked up.
Yeah.
That's like some fucking god level shit.
Yeah, so you like walk down the street, and it's like a regular main street for like a hot minute, and then it kind of goes off into like a split, and down the way that you look down that split, like it just goes off into emptiness. Like there's like maybe like six shops, and then it dead cuts into the fissure.
Well, Ela's gonna go into one of the shops, just.
So you see what looks to be a sheriff station. There's a little general store. There's a bakery. There's a cobbler and a tailor shop that are kind of connected to each other. There's a town hall and a tavern off in the distance by a kind of semi-submerged bridge. There's a stable and a post office, and that's like they all have like signs.
I'm gonna go to the general store.
Okay. So the general store is one of the buildings that's a little bit singed, but it's at the back. The front of the store is still like pretty. One of the windows has been smashed, and as you go in, it looks like most of what was there was taken.
Okay.
It looks pretty empty in there.
Can I?
You can definitely make an investigation. Yeah. You can make an investigation check to check.
I'll help.
Ooh! 18 plus 5.
Whoa.
23.
Okay. What? So, in the area where the register kind of looks like it was, like, they took the register with them, there's, like, a bit of dust where it was, like, lifted and then taken.
Okay.
You can tell that some of the things were jostled out of it. And in the like, cracks of the floorboards, you find 5 gold, which is fucking
yay! Money!
So, you also notice the door to the back room is like slightly ajar, and when you look in there, there's like some crates and stuff.
Ooh, I am absolutely gonna take my crowbar out and open those crates.
Ooh. There's some nice silks and stuff in there.
I'm so glad I have a crowbar.
Okay, is it possible for me to make a investigation check based off of like my history on seeing shit like this?
Yeah, you can definitely make a history check to see if this is similar to anything you've like experienced like heard about before. You're also like old; you would have probably heard about this.
Yeah, exactly. Give me a second.
Elo, you also find some calligrapher supplies, included with some more expensive inks. There's some like fancy paper and ink in here.
Okay.
And also, like, you know, just some like mystic tools and stuff.
Okay. I'm definitely going to take the calligrapher supplies and as much of the silk as I can, because that will sell. For money!
Money!
I'll say you find, like, 2 bolts of, like, the fancy fabric.
Okay. Mark that down.
Alright, so, Cresty, your history check.
22.
So, you've been around for a while. You know that this fissure wasn't always here. So the fact that this town has kind of been sliced in half by it doesn't seem totally weird to you. You've heard of, like, other towns that have been, like, broken apart by this fissure in the past.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And, like, you know that people usually, like, take advantage of the fact that these towns have, like, lost a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And so most of them have been abandoned, totally abandoned, because half of their community has either fallen in or is, like, literally like 1,000 miles away from them at this point. It's like really hard to get your community back together when it has literally been split in half.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
Yeah, so there's been some bandits that have gone through here and cleaned things out.
Okay. That's fucked up.
You also have no idea why the fissure happened in the first place. Okay. This has been like a massive mystery that no one's like been able to look into, and there have been like scientists on it, but you know,
But have there been multiple fissures, it sounds like? Just the one. Just the one? Okay.
It just keeps
Do I know about how long ago this happened? Or no?
Yeah, it was about, I would say anywhere from 150 to 100 years ago. At that point of time in your life, you weren't paying enough attention to it.
Okay, yeah, I was fucking busy.
I'm gonna do an investigation check to see if there's anything familiar.
Okay,
sure. I probably won't get anything. Yeah, that's a 5.
Yeah. Nope, you're looking around the general store where everybody else seems to be collected, and it's like, it's alien in here, you haven't been in society long enough for you to, like, get goods and commerce, really. So standing in a store is just kind of like, I don't understand this, this has nothing to do with me.
Yeah, I don't like it here, we should leave.
are there any shops that sell, like, medical herbs or, like, medical stuff or anything like that?
I mean, if continuing down the main road, just kind of looking around, you can tell there was a shop that used to be kind of like a pharmacy, but that one has cracked in half and fallen into the fissure.
Ah, shit, never mind.
I was kind of curious, because you said that there was a post office. I was kind of curious about that, seeing if maybe there might be some clues or something left behind. Yeah, for sure. What happened? Cool. Kind of going down the street, going to the post office, there's a little, like... This town is, like, very Western looking, so it has, like, a post out front for horses.
That's cute.
Yes. It's real cute, but there are no horses.
No! So, literally, no! What the fuck is the point? I hate this fucking game!
What?
Well, Ela might like it.
I'm enjoying this town of no horses.
So you went to the post office. It's dusty like everything else here. This building is one of the ones that have been untouched. It's got a little bit of water damage because the river is trying to consume the rest of the bank that's next to the town. You know, it's relatively fine. Roll investigation check. Alright. Oh no. Sound. I got a 1.
Oh, King. Oh. You've got some bad luck.
Yeah. You look around, but you know, you're not a postal worker. It occurs to you that looking at other people's mail is illegal, and you get a bit, like,
oh no.
You get the feeling in the pit of your stomach, like, oh no, this is bad, and then you leave. by the horse post, feeling awkward about trying to look at other people's mail for a minute.
That's pretty good.
Make yourself cry about committing crimes against people who aren't here.
Like, I'm a bad person. Anyone else want to do anything?
After Elo goes out of the store, he's gonna go over to Dante.
God damn it, can you fucking leave me alone?
What the fuck? I'm trying to. You know what? No, I'm not.
That was internal.
Elo heard that. roll an internal monologue check to make sure Dante didn't just say that shit out loud.
He's old, he rambles.
He does ramble. You shouldn't take him seriously. What the fuck are you coming up to me for?
I was gonna give you something nice, but now I don't want to.
Did Dante actually
just say that in his mind?
Yes, I just said that to you. That wasn't Dante.
Oh my God. Hila's gonna come up with the calligrapher's supplies.
Mm-hmm.
And just sort of like... He kind of just pulls them out. And just kind of like, hey, you want to buy these from me? I'll give you a criminal discount.
Is the hand trained that I have? Is it trained?
It's.
Are you gonna try and steal from me?
No. I'm asking if he can do a basic movement.
If you ask him nicely,
I want him to flip Elo off.
Okay. Yeah. No. Wholeheartedly.
Oh.
I'm very sorry, but this man has been nice.
Elo hates hands now.
his face darkens immediately. I'm so sorry.
It's my money.
I'm a greedy bastard.
Did you even mention how much you were charging for?
No,
no,
didn't even
he was
ask for a
no,
price.
Not at
I
all.
I would have given you a really good deal. Is the thing?
Is this expensive magic paper or is this shitty fucking wannabe calligraphy paper?
Make an arcana check.
And I rolled an 18.
Yeah, it's fucking magic paper.
God damn it! How fucking much is it?
I'll give it to you for a single gold piece.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay.
Well.
I told you I would give you a good deal. You just have to be nice, oh, fucking asshole.
This is like the first step to Dante becoming nice. I will give you 2 gold coins.
Hila will absolutely take that deal.
So Dante, you now have 200 gold worth of ink and paper.
You're welcome.
No.
Well, I apologize. And I hold my hand out to shake as like an apology, a formal apology to Elo.
Elo will do the thing again where he like regurgitates slime, spits it into his hand, and then shakes his hand.
He's like, Dante is grimacing, but he's like, all right, cool.
The hand scuttles down Dante's arm and like does that thing when you like, the thing where you do an intimate handshake where you like hold with both hands. Except Dante's hand is one of them, and the hand is the other.
Oh, he is an extension of me.
Can I use mage hand to do that with five?
Yes!
This is complete nonsense. And Dante smiles. Dante smiles very widely. You see almost all of the teeth.
When Elo smiles, you just see slime filling in to try and make teeth. Smile.
We are fucked up.
Gash has been watching the entire fucking time. She's really confused.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Anytime.
Oh my fucking
Internally,
God.
She's like, so this is what commerce is like.
Elo just wanted to do something nice for his friend. But also get money out of it.
You know what? You're gonna get the best reading of the Very Hungry Caterpillar tonight.
Yes!
As a question for the DM, is there any store in here that Dante would find worth walking into? Otherwise, he's not gonna bother with anything.
I'm gonna go to the tavern next. I wanna look at, spaces
for if it's already been looted.
Sleeping.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's a tailor and a cobbler.
Wait a second, a tavern? You mean alcohol?
Yeah, there's a tavern.
Ooh.
Okay, first of all, I would like to make a stop at the tailor to see if I can find any good clothes. He's been wearing a lot of black for a while.
Oh man, you know what would be cute?
What?
Giving Gash like a little like babushka head, like headscarf.
Dante's gonna go shopping for the rest of him. He's gonna walk in, pull out a basket.
You just drag Gash along with you.
Come on, children, time to go get clothes.
Xenoma walks in and just plays dress up with everybody.
Xenoma has been in the tailor shop while you guys have been talking. So, like, the moment Dante enters, Xenobar is just kind of like, hello.
I just like the idea.
Shoves you out of the way and goes straight for the black.
Party fashion montage.
Anyone who wants to look in the tailor's shop has to make an investigation check for
me. Okay.
Nat 1.
I got a 23. Yeah.
I got 17.
I got 17 too.
Entering the store makes Elo realize that Elo already has fabric, which means capes. So Elo just kind of like uses the fabric to make capes for fucking Gash and Elo at the front of the store. Gash literally can't see anything because Elo just tossed a fucking cape over her head.
I'm like a fucking dog that got a blanket tossed over me. You see her just like kind of rotate like 45 degrees back and forth for like a minute.
She is trying her best.
Elo's desperately trying to like get the like, fabric on.
Alright.
Is my 17 canceled out because of that one? Because I can't see.
For anyone who rolled over a 15, you get a cool new fashion item, but it's old. So all of it is a little bit outdated in terms of, like, the trends of the time.
Fucking My Chemical Romance t-shirt from Hot Topic.
Xanavar, you find a neat new pair of gloves. These are just like some simple white gloves, a little bit more fancy than the ones that you're wearing. So when you enter high society once more, it'll be, you know,
you'll
better
fit in
for your appearance. Dante.
Yes.
You find like a new undershirt for your robe. It is black. You did succeed in finding black. Fujio, you find a nice little, like, it's like a little robe thing. It's like a little silk robe. It's like a solid color, but like it's got some nice like embroidery along the collar of it. It's just like, it's nice and pretty, and you look at it and it's like, ooh, nice. Ooh, like nice. It.
Yeah.
Nice,
yeah.
I like it.
Nice. Yeah.
You guys all went to the tailor shop.
What yeah, cool. We looted.
I want to go to the tavern at some point.
Okay.
We can probably do that now. Yeah, I think we're done here.
Like, lime and shit.
Yeah.
I'm looking for more alcohol. Cool.
You guys exit the tailor shop and you go across the little, like, wooden pathway that they've built, like, connecting the buildings together. And you enter into the tavern. It's got those fucking saloon doors. And most of the tables have, like, or they're just in, like, a regular position, but, like, some chairs have, like, been put up on top of the table, and some of them have been put down as, like, you know, bandits stay the night there. It's an empty tavern. There's some staircases leading up to some rooms upstairs. Like, a whole section of the wall is dedicated to the bar, but, like, most of the bottles have been, like, cast aside and stuff. Some of them are broken.
Is there anything salvageable?
Make an investigation check.
Well, I got a 22.
You open it, it's the wine cellar, and that
fuck
hasn't
yes.
been touched. There's a couple bottle of wine.
Nice.
You find two whole bottles of wine that have not been opened yet.
Fuck
and because
yes.
this town is so fucking old, the vintage is great.
Yes, champagne baby, aged.
Dante has a whore shirt, a dead rat, very hungry caterpillar,
a fancy drow perfume, a broken crossbow, a transmutation arcane side sigil. Two bottles of wine that he's gonna have a great time with.
If he ever dies and his body gets looted, the next person who finds him is just gonna be like, what the fuck? What's this guy doing?
Speaking of which, going through inventory, it smells. It's a smelly bag.
That's what the perfume's for.
You guys put your horses away for the night. Do you guys want to sleep in the tavern itself, or do you guys want to go up to the rooms?
I'm gonna go up to the room.
There's about three rooms. One of them is slightly bigger than the other ones, but, you know.
I want to take
nice.
The big room immediately.
I also want to take the big room.
Like I want to take it. The big room.
God damn it. Right
while they're all fighting, Elo's just gonna slip into one of the smaller rooms.
Don't
make himself comfortable.
Two of you, but I need some beauty sleep after such a long trip. Plus,
yay.
God damn it. Can you shut the fuck up? Can you please shut the fuck up?
Gash fucking glares at you. You see her fucking, like, disheveled ass hair and the one eye peeking out from behind it. The dazed level of exhaustion that you've seen settling in for the past 24 hours. As soon as you say, I need my beauty sleep. You sent some fucking murderous intent from this woman.
For a split second, you see every one of Dante's wrinkles. Like fucking Squidward!
Hello in the other room, just fucking shivers like his whole body.
It's funny because Gash has a level of exhaustion, but Dante just looks like that.
That's so funny. Okay, so obviously me and Gash will get the rooms. Goodbye, Xanavar. Go sleep in your other room. Okay, that's the thing I kind of hate, love, about our fucking party is that we've got, like, a fucking horrible, devastated village, and we're all just laughing our asses off upstairs in this fucking tavern, stealing shit, arguing with each other, like, none of it matters.
I think we've determined that none of us are good people.
Except for maybe Fujio, maybe.
Not for much longer. I mean, we met in jail, guys.
Okay, so I'm assuming Dante and Gash just go ahead in the big room and just take it. Now, here's the real question. How many beds are there in this room?
Yeah, how many beds are there?
It's just one big bed.
Oh shit. Fujio, come over here.
There's a tub, but there's no bathroom. You know, this was before the widespread implementation of plumbing.
This brings Dante back. This brings him back to old days.
Okay,
so well, who's taking the bed?
Gash flops down face first, ass out on the bed.
And we can't share the bed? That's fucked up.
You could.
I sleep on one side, you sleep on the other. I won't touch you, don't worry about it. Is the bed big enough for both Gash and Dante? Is the real question.
Well, Dante is long and Gash is wide. So with the average person, it would be enough to fit two. Because Dante is long and Gash is wide, it still fits two. Just differently.
She, as soon as she fucking hits that mattress, she's passing out. So she's not gonna resist you, like kind of scooching in there.
He's also completely out.
Alright, so two of them are passed out. What do the rest of you guys do?
I went into one of the smaller rooms while they was all arguing.
Okay, you sleep then?
So I got myself set up nice and cozy.
Okay. Is Dante Jr. also sleeping?
Yeah, Dante's like, I'm trying to describe the hand motion I am making at the moment. It's like, kind of the fingers are a little bit curled up, it's...
Like a dead spider.
It is the equivalent of, like, a cat curled up on a chest.
Okay, that's
like,
really cute. Around.
Yeah.
That's really sweet. Yeah.
So, okay. Xanavar, where is he? Where he's in the other room?
Yeah. Has Fujio already grabbed one of the beds?
I wasn't sure. Y'all were all scrambling, so I don't know if I grabbed one.
I'm gonna say Fujio was downstairs tacking the horses. Or, like, unpacking, I guess is the word for it.
I feel like he... first check the entire room in the bed to see if, like, he doesn't trust this bed, and he's checking mercilessly for the sheets and the blankets, like,
this better not have blood on it, so
like that. Yeah. And if it's gross, if it's like dirty and old, he keeps going, just saying fuck it, I'm sleeping in the wagon.
Yeah, it's gross. It's gross old bed. It's old.
Okay, he just says, fuck it, I'm sleeping in the wagon. He just literally just walked out of the tower, of that tavern, because he's like...
Goodbye.
Goodbye, bitch.
Before he leaves the tavern, he's just like, I hope you're happy and your little rotting carcasses. Just leaves. Just hit him in the big bed. He's angry.
I love that he's a bitch. It's funny.
Fujio passes Xanavar on the way down, and while Fujio is on the way up.
Xanavar is gonna be really pissed when he finds out that Ela was just sleeping on the floor. Not even in the bed. Ela's never slept on a bed before. His family never gave him one.
Ela tells Xan that he slept on the floor, and he's like, I'm taking it back. I'm not buying you anything. And then he's like, traitor.
Ela would be so hurt. So
Ela will remember this.
Dante, right before he and Gash like actually hit the hay, he's like, careful, I sleep in the nude.
The murder-
makes me feel spry.
The comes 2 degrees colder.
Oh, God.
Speaking of which, it does get colder. Like, a lot fucking
Dante,
colder.
Dante freezes.
His fat ass keeps him warm.
You guys all try to get as toasty as you can.
Well, I mean, sleeping next to Gash, you must be freaking warm
Gash
as hell.
Yeah, Gash is really fucking warm, but like, Xanavar, no way. Xanavar is fucking freezing outside.
Bet you feel bad about sleeping outside, don't you?
Wait, isn't there like a coat on the wagon to like cover it?
No, like, bitch, yeah, it's open.
Moonbright is fucking cold, right? Like,
it's like coastal, so it's temperate, I guess. Right,
well, he's like, you, Papa didn't raise no bitch. I can do this.
Yeah.
Are you sure about
it
that?
It definitely reminds you of some of the rougher nights that you've had. So the evening gets colder. It gets dark. Looking out through any of the windows in any of your rooms, and Xanavar especially, because you're sleeping outside. You cannot see more than 5 feet in front of you because it is misty and dark.
You love that.
As the night continues on, as the darkness kind of like settles in, and most of you are like nodding off to sleep, the hours pass by. 1, 2. So, Xanavar, it's cold. It's really fucking cold. You can feel it. You can feel it in your bones, through your skin. It's like it is clawing its way through you. It's holding you in a chilly embrace. And as the hours go on, you can't really find yourself hitting sleep as quickly as usual, just because, you know, it's cold and you've got some bad memories associated with similar situations like this. And you almost don't catch it at first. You hear something. Make a perception check for me.
Oh, sweet boy.
We are all gonna get killed in our sleep.
Because he didn't want to sleep in a bloody bed.
Nice campaign, everyone.
Oh shit, I got a 9.
Okay, that's fine.
For the DM.
Yeah, so you hear something in the distance, and it sounds kind of shrill. You might think it's an animal. It's coming from the same direction as the temple.
Okay.
It might be a bat or something. At least for the first few minutes you do. It steadily gets louder.
Oh no.
And that's when the rest of you guys hear it. Just this awful wailing noise.
Oh no.
And you're all tired. You're all fucking tired. It's been a long fucking day. It's been a rough day, especially because it's been so cold. And all of you just want to, like, snuggle up and get warm. And no matter what you do, you cannot get warm.
Fuck.
And not, like, to the point where you're freezing to death or anything, but it's just, like, this chill that settles under you. And it just gets louder and louder until it's unbearable and echoing across the fissure. You can hear it in your ears, and at some point it doesn't even sound like it's coming from outside anymore. It sounds like it's coming from in your own heads.
Oh shit.
Oh my god.
So I guess all these motherfuckers are up. I'm gonna want to go investigate, probably. Just to fucking punch whoever's screaming.
I'm gonna fucking get a second level of exhaustion. Jesus Christ. If I can't fucking pass out, I'm gonna go with intent to kill.
I feel like Zan would have put on his shoes and gotten up to investigate further.
All of you kind of collect in front of the tavern, all sleepy, all very cold. You're kind of like bundled up in blankets and stuff. Some of you are in your pee gaze. and you all look off in the distance. Again, it is very hard to see in the dark, even for the people who have dark vision. It's like the mist is just absolutely destroying any sense of like more than 15 feet in front of you.
Man, I really hate that fucking serial killer shit.
So across the street from the tavern is the general store, and then just behind that is like a little house. And then, you know, right after that, there's the temple. You don't really notice it at first. Just because it's, like, hidden behind the general store. It's one of the bigger buildings. There's, like, a hazy, kind of bluish-green light that's, like, coming from behind it.
Okay. Oh.
We're gonna die.
Well, I guess we're gonna start walking towards that.
Well,
yes. Zanon has a bit of a shit. He's walking towards it.
Yeah, Gash is
also. How are you walking towards it?
Slowly.
Slowly. Yeah.
My fucking aching knees, man. My rheumatism is not feeling good right now. The cold.
I'm keeping pace with everybody.
Check for me then.
I rolled a 9.
Ooh, nat 20.
Whoa! I got a 10.
Elo and his juicy ass just fade into the mist.
Ooh, I got a 17.
Yeah, so that's generally pretty good, except for Dante, which is hilarious because it's in front. You get a better look at the house that's behind it. And the house is like one of the buildings that's actually really fucked up. It's completely toasted. Half of it's fallen into the fissure. What used to be a garden is literally just like charcoal next to it. Like one of the doors has been busted down. It's just, it doesn't look good. The window's been smashed. It's a bad looking house. Don't look great. and the glow is coming from like right in the middle of it. And since most of the walls have been like, you know, they've fallen apart, this house isn't steady. The roof isn't even like in the house anymore. Like it has completely fucking fallen apart. And the sobbing, while it's in your ears, you can tell it is definitely coming from the light there.
It's crying?
Yep.
It's just the Victorian kid from the other
day. I'm gonna beat his ass!
Alright, can I get an order of, like, a walking order?
I'll go first.
Yeah, you can go first.
For once. Since I got the highest stealth roll, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Got the worst.
I guess. Zana gonna be the back every time.
Well, I rolled a fucking 9. His bones aren't feeling too good.
So you guys get closer and closer to this building. The crying from earlier is still like there, but obviously it's in front of you also, and it kind of like resonates like through the cavern. Because it looks like this light is just sobbing into it.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Like directly staring into it, sobbing down into it. The closer you get, you can see the figure of a woman. Gently, delicately floating, her hair kind of, you know, caught in a wind that, well, the wind does exist, but it's not moving with the wind. Like, it's not moving with the gusts of the wind. She's wearing antiquated clothing. Clearly she died a long time ago.
Oh my god.
And in front of you, the ghost kind of, it's kind of a spectral glitching where she kind of moves to the front of the house for a second. She's just like walking, no longer crying. She kneels in the area in front of the house where there was probably something because she's kneeling next to it. And she's just kind of like whispering to herself. She like delicately places a kiss on someone who is not there, and she stands up, and then she goes and sits in a place that no longer has a chair on the other side of the room, and then she perks up like she's heard a loud noise, and she scrambles away from where the door has fallen off of its hinges, away from where she was sitting, and then she looks outside the door to where all of you are standing, and she screams. I would like all of you to roll initiative for me, please.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No. Oh, thank god I rolled something good for once. I got a 21.
Oh no, not one. I feel like every fight,
Seven.
Leo, like, fucking falls on his ass. Like,
it's the shoes.
I specifically gave him, like, a big plus in acrobatics to make up for the shoe balancing thing. Yeah. And yet, this keeps happening.
Okay, well, I rolled my, what's it called? To cast a fucking spell.
Your spell attack?
Yeah, I got a 21.
What are you hitting her with?
Let's see. I'm a little confused because I don't think I fought a ghost before. So I'm just going to play it safe and cast Ray of Frost. And I got a 7.
Okay, so 7 damage?
Yeah.
All right.
That's it.
So you, being the one who investigated her in the first place, notices, like, right away when she starts freaking out at all of you. So you blast your ray of frost at her, and she, like, it hits her, but it does nothing. There's no sign that the frost did anything to her. And she, like, stares at the rest of you, still screaming her fucking head off. And while it's not easy to understand, like, it sounds like it's warbled, like it's being caught in the wind and being, like, dragged away before it can really get anywhere. She's saying, "You do not touch her!"
The ghost said that?
It is now Elo's turn, unless Dante wants to make a movement.
I'm just gonna move back.
Can I see anything inside the house?
Inside the house, there's that broken doorway. There's what looks like what used to be like a box of some kind, but it's got like linens and stuff in it, and like the top of it has been like completely destroyed. For the most part, anything that used to be furniture, anything that used to be like things that proved that a person lived there, they've been completely destroyed.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Is there, like, a window, like, right here?
Yeah, it's very small, but you're a small guy, so you can do that
if you want. Can I squeeze through it?
Yeah, sure. Can you make a quick acrobatics check for me? It'll be low DC.
Okay. 18.
Ooh. Yep, you do it.
Okay. And then I'm just gonna ready an action that if she comes towards me, I'm going to cast Douse on her, but otherwise I'll end my turn there.
You're gonna make her a soggy ghost.
All right, after Elo slings through the window, this woman, immediately after getting hit by Dante, after her, like, her horrified scream at all of you, she yells again, and this time it hurts, y'all. It's not fun. No. I would like all of you to make a charisma saving throw for me.
Oh, no. I'm bad at 5.
Okay.
4.
Oh my god,
okay.
I got a nat 20 plus
3. 11. Fujio, you're generally a very empathetic person, so the moment she screams, you can hear the anguish in her voice, and it hits you with the kind of sadness that you haven't felt since you first left your village all of those, like, weeks ago.
Oh my god.
And it hits you how much it sucks to not have your family around, and how much it sucks to not be around people who recognize you. And then you realize that you've never really known your family, and that hits you so hard that you fall to the ground. And then Elo, you hear this protective female voice screaming out, hoping to protect someone she cares about. and you recognize that no one has ever felt like that about you before.
Oh. Oh, shit, dog.
You also fall to the ground. Krusty, you got a 5?
Yeah.
He hears the cry and realizes his ass is flat.
God damn it. Fuck y'all.
Dante hears the wail, and it strikes something so personal and secret to you that it reminds you of the night when everything went wrong.
Everything went to shit.
And you fall to your knees. Everyone who failed that check takes 5 psychic damage. You also are incapacitated until you make another saving throw. Anyone who wasn't affected by it takes 2 damage. Yeah. And the woman stays where she is. It is now Gash's turn.
Shit. I'm gonna rage.
Okay.
You're gonna freak it?
I'm going to attack. It's 12 to hit.
Yep, that just hits.
I'm going to do a thunderous blow. Once per turn while raging, when you damage a creature with a melee attack, you can force the target to make a strength saving throw. On a failure, you push the target 5 feet away from you, and you can choose to immediately move 5 feet into the target's previous position. I don't know if she's gonna fall, because she's a ghost, but I'm just trying to, like, get her away.
Nothing gained by not trying.
Yeah! Okay, she has to make a DC 13 strength saving throw.
So, wild
and
thing
also,
about...
oh shit, I forgot to roll damage, god damn it. There's so many things to roll.
Wild thing about ghosts, they don't have any muscles, so they're not very strong.
Okay. I really thought you were gonna say they don't have any muscles, so they can't be hit. And I was gonna be like, yeah, fuck. God damn it. I got
13.
13, great.
Yeah, 13.
Beware, I'm a gay and I can do math.
Oh yeah. No.
Pushes.
The ghost
push
is
away.
Pushed back. The moment you push the ghost away from the doorway, she looks startled and afraid, and she looks over to where Elo is.
Oh shit!
Oh no!
Alright, it is now Xanabar's turn.
Can I roll, like, a persuasion or a performance check to maybe actually try to calm this really sad spirit down?
So you can roll Arcana, you can roll Religion, or you can roll Insight.
Alright, I'm gonna roll Arcana.
Okay.
Ah, shit, I got a 10.
Okay. From what you can tell, this woman is angry. This woman is scared. This woman is also a ghost, so it is unlikely that you will be able to reason with her. She has already died.
Maybe I can't do shit with the ghost, but maybe these two, I can kind of help them. I'm going to give inspiration to Dante and give help to Fujio.
And so Fujio's getting help, actually. Great. Because it is Fujio's turn. So roll your saving throw with advantage.
Unnatural 20.
Yeah, no, you totally pass. Xanabar kind of calms you down, and you recognize that, like, you've never been alone. Family isn't the people who birth you, it's the people you spend time with, and, like, Xanabar gives you a charming smile, and you're like, haha, wow, horrible, and you get back up.
Dante's in the back, like,
yeah. And that's your turn.
Okay, so I have to do another roll to see if I get out of this thing. So I did, yeah, I rolled a 16. Thank God, because I had a -1 in charisma.
It's been over for a very long time. You recognize that there's no point being sad about it. You've already been sad about it so fucking long already.
He's already that depressed. He's like, what the fuck is wrong with me?
Yeah, he's just like, why am I so affected by this? Literally, it has been a problem for fucking years now. There's no point in crying about something that's already bad and has happened a while ago.
He's like, wait a second, I'm harder than this. And then he stops crying. The tears get sucked back into his head.
Wait a minute, I can't cry in front of the women.
He's bi.
Alright, I'm gonna attempt to recover from my existential dread of absolute loneliness.
Yes, please roll a charisma saving throw.
I'm sorry, 14. Baby, I can only save 2.
Yep, you make it. It is now the ghost's turn again.
I feel bad for this woman.
I feel bad for her too.
I feel bad, but we can't seem to reason with her.
So the woman looks over at Elo, who has, like, been trembling in fear for, like, in the corner of the room. But she looks at where he is, and she gets instantly angry again. So she is going to use a spell attack on him. Uh-oh!
No!
Don't do that. So she does hit you.
Oh shit.
It's not fun. Her spectral hand kind of moves towards you, in a similar way to your mage hand, except this one is translucent. You can see your skeleton through it. It's got like wisps of white like pouring off of it, and it feels cold the closer it gets to you.
Oh my god.
You take 14 points of damage.
Cold
damage.
Oh no.
She's turning him into a jello.
I'm dying.
Oh no.
Yeah, the ghost reaches towards Elo and she screams, "Get away from her!" And then she like turns back to Gash in front of her and she moves over through here. Over to where Elo is.
I get an attack of opportunity, right?
Oh, wait,
yeah, get
she's within 5 feet of me now, too, right?
Yeah.
That triggers my attack of opportunity.
Holy shit.
Well,
two
you were stunned, and it's your turn now,
right.
So technically the action you held isn't there anymore.
Damn it. Aww. This juicy ass goes to waste.
No. That's a fucking 24 to hit.
That does it.
Do not fucking touch my boy. Damn. Low damage. 6 damage.
Okay, great. It does not do as much as you think it would. It's Gash's turn.
Is there a way to get, like, in between her and Elo?
That's you can do that. That's your movement.
Yep, I'm wedging myself there. Gash's best use is a wall. Let's see what I got. I think I'm going to make another attack, and I'm going to do a thunderous blow. So I'm gonna attack, and she's gotta make a strength saving throw.
Okay.
Let's see. Whoa! Nat 20 to hit!
Oh,
yes!
Man. You get to double that damage, baby!
Killer!
Oh, shit! So that's 25 to hit. That's 9 damage times 2, which is 18 damage. I'm gonna attempt to push her 5 feet. That 5 feet that away. It would make sense.
And your DC was 13 for that, right?
I believe so.
Again, no muscles, not strong. She fails.
Yeah.
As she stumbles, back, she looks horrified.
And I'm gonna move here. I'm gonna protect my boy.
Okay. As she stumbles back again, looks horrified. Okay, Xanabar goes next.
So, getting like climb in the window and kind of heal my boy Elo.
You could probably heal me from the other side of the window.
Yeah, you could probably just reach your hand through the window and get him.
Yeah,
I got a 5.
Okay, so Elo gets 5 HP. You want to do anything else with your turn?
Can I detect or do fairy fire to see if there's any other ghosts around here? Or something like that.
I'm gonna say as DM that's fine, because healing word is a bonus action, so.
Yeah, it's 4 squares wide, so it's not that
much. Damn it, I thought I could get, like, the whole town, never mind.
I tip my fedora.
That's something to do with your guy.
Okay, I'm gonna give him help, because he was the only one who I did not comfort by the lady's screams. It's okay, your ass is still fat, kid.
Okay, I, like, because we were trying to reason with her, but I'm wondering if we just shout, like, "Do you want us to leave? We can fucking leave!" would work. Would she respond to that?
I mean, you can try it. Talking's a free action.
Okay, I just want to say that before I do anything.
Okay, roll a persuasion check.
Okay. Not very good. 9.
Yeah. No. You get the impression she's not really listening. This would have been an insanely high DC either way.
Okay. I'm gonna use my thaumaturgy to, manifest a booming loud voice and just scream back at her just to see if she'll, like, do something. Because I didn't like how she was screaming earlier, and I'm just gonna be like, "Hey!" I wanna basically say the same thing, like, "Stop hurting us, we can leave. Like, you're sad or something, right? Just listen to me."
Okay, I'm gonna give you the same option that I gave Xanabar earlier. You can roll Insight, you can roll Religion, or you can roll Arcana.
I'm gonna do insight. I got a 16.
Oh, that's pretty good. Looking at this woman, or what you see from this woman, through like the window that you can kind of, you know, peek through. This woman is just, she's a ghost, and ghosts are kind of stuck on this world. That's the whole nature of them. Like, they can't get to the other side. This woman is reliving the worst moment of her life. It is Dante's turn. Dante, what would you like to do?
Is that better? Running. So, have we already established that there's no way to convince her? Is there a way that I can roll something high enough to convince her? Like a persuasion check?
Try rolling persuasion.
Well, I do have that extra d6 that I could.
Yeah, if you want to try.
I got a 20, but the minus 1 makes it a 19. Plus...
Wait, that, you got a nat 20?
Yes, but I have a negative one in fucking...
No, what
that doesn't matter.
That's
matter.
That's
oh, wait.
That's the best you can possibly get.
Hold oh, on. I thought it was like...
You might actually fucking get the ghost.
No, well, I'm gonna go ahead and add that d6 that's anyways, and it's a 6. It's a 26.
Oh my god, wow.
Shut the fuck up! Stop being sad! Go away!
She kind of scrambles back, and she's like, oh my god!
Oh my god!
You have managed to break her out of a cycle that she has been trapped in for 100 years by screaming shut the fuck up at her.
What the fuck?
He's pissed.
So powerful.
He's pissed off because his ray of frost didn't hit. She's got fucking cold immunity. He's probably a little out of it mentally anyways because of the fact that he just got re-traumatized for no fucking reason.
Like, yes. The ghost is just, like, fucking having the worst day, just looks over to see who's screaming, and it's just that, like...
So, like, the woman looks where she's been staring the entire time, and she, like, blanks, like, she's, like, recognizing that there's nothing there anymore, and then she looks over at the giant crevasse next to her, and she's like, what's happening?
And she are we out up. Of... battle?
Yeah. You
okay,
broke
so
her out of it.
Fuck.
Nice.
Oh, wow.
Gash points, like, at the fucking fissure next to them. I'm gonna try doing another insight. But I still have this advantage. Shit. God damn it. 9.
Yep. She's freaked out. A little less freaked. She's not, like, hostile anymore, but she's, like, definitely... wigging the fuck out. There's like
ghost.
A level of like catching up with herself because she was caught in the middle of the loop while you guys were attacking her.
Wow.
And she's just kind of like catching up with the rest of what would have happened in her mind.
Okay. Wow. I'm gonna put my club down. And I'm going to attempt to communicate. The town is empty. Everyone is gone.
Okay. Roll performance. At disadvantage because you're exhausted.
Hey, any of you want to fucking help me?
I can help. I have performance.
You guys can just use your words.
Yeah.
She only has to use performance because she.
Yeah, I was like, Dante was just gonna walk up to her and be like, "Who are you? What's your fucking problem?"
My name's Dolly.
Dolly.
I don't know what happened. Everything's different and wrong, and I don't know where my. I don't know where my daughter went.
Elo is recovering from his injuries. He's not gonna help out.
My goodness, there is nothing to be afraid of. This town is abandoned.
It's a bit, but no, it's everyone with.
She like peeks out from behind the doorway and she like looks around and sees like what has happened to the town, and she's like, oh, well, fuck.
Well spoken. Well fucking spoken. I like her.
Well, she's like a little squirrely about touches at the moment. Like it's clear that she was in an altercation just before she died.
Yeah.
And, like, the whole touching thing and the fact that you guys have weapons on you still is still kind of freaking her out. But clearly you guys aren't hostile anymore. She just needs space. So she kind of like steps back a minute.
Do any of you know what happened here or I remember people coming in and somebody warning me about something my husband did, and I my 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 they they wanted my daughter, and I did not let them in. I didn't want them to get her. I told her to run out the back, and she ran out the back, and suddenly everything was broken, and it was hot. It hurt so bad.
Miss, we do not know what happened in this town. We have only just got here by nightfall. He just found you in this house screaming. And we don't know what happened. When we got here, this town was abandoned and no one was living here. We were searching and we don't know where your daughter is. And could you tell us anything about your daughter? Is there anywhere where she could have gone or could have went?
Well, first off, I want to know what year does this woman think it is?
Yeah, what?
Well, didn't I make a check earlier? Like, that this apparently fucking happened, like, 100-something years ago?
The year that she says is equivalent to about 120 years ago.
Ooh, right. You see Dante wince.
She was about yay high. She's only about 7. She was wearing her night clothes when she ran out the back. The back door is gone.
Is this a human ghost?
Yes, she's human.
Okay.
Her right. daughter's dead.
Like, you don't want to say it.
I want Fujio to just, he's just going to ask, are you by chance religious in any way? I'm not very familiar with the Ska, but I know that they're rather against necromancy. And I think the best way I can explain this to you is it has been more than 100 years since you have died. You are currently dead and you are stuck between worlds.
Oh no. The priest always warned us about things like this. About unresolved whatevers. We had a ghost once outside of town. There was a lady, her name was Beatrice. Her husband died and he just would not leave that house. And eventually they had to get a guy in, an exorcist, who worked for the Peller Faith. And it was not pretty. But I guess there's no exorcist here anymore. Am I stuck?
I think you're a little stuck.
And I have a question. How old is this ghost? Like, does she look? How old does she look? Is she hot?
Yeah. No, she's kind of your type.
All right. Hey. He's like sliding his hair back.
About a passionate mother that really gets
you. He's a fucking dilf. He pulls out that drow fucking cologne and just does a little spritz. What are you doing tonight?
Wait, real quick. Lucio sees like this shit Dante pulling, and he speaks up, like, "By the way, did you have a husband before?" Like
that? You know, that isn't gonna stop me. Actually, you know how many marriages I've ruined.
She like turns around to all of you, just like, "Why do you care about my husband? Oh my god, my daughter is probably dead. I am not interested."
Well, I just got rejected. Well, is this ghost gonna join us on our sexy adventures,
Miss Dolly? We're on a journey right now. We were just stopping here briefly, so I don't know if we're going to be able to stay here very long. We can certainly try to help you if you have any ideas, but otherwise, we're going to have to keep going at some point.
I don't think I can leave. Just thinking about what I know from the whole thing that happened with Beatrice's husband. He couldn't leave either. He was stuck in that house, and she walks past and through, especially Dante, because he's in the fucking doorway. he goes through all of you, and she gets about as far as the step before she is, like, stops.
He's like, whoo!
Is there any way that we can, like, free her?
Could we, like, give her closure on her daughter? Maybe that could help her pass on.
Yeah.
From what I remember, it requires an exorcism, which will probably hurt, or, I guess closure. I would like to know where my daughter went. What happened here, maybe? Those are the two things that come to mind. I don't want to know anything about what happened to my husband. That man is dead to me.
Thank God. Oh, so there is a chance.
I'm
Ela's gonna finally speak up at this point. Just like, her husband worked at the big stone temple, right?
Oh, no, my husband wasn't a holy man. Anything from it, actually. He was kind of a layabout. He had a lot of issues. I actually didn't see much of him. Or hadn't seen much of him in my last few years of life, I guess.
Many shit.
Oh, sorry.
Was this area always this foggy and cold?
Oh, no, this used to be a farming community. Before this whole big crack in the ground happened, and you can see like she's having like a mental block at the fact that it's there. She's like, there used to be other houses and farms and fields all the way back there. I mean, we lived in town, but there were lots of people in the rest of the community that were just that way. I mean, obviously they're not anymore.
Elo thinks that the temple might be symptomatic of the issue.
So we should go investigate.
Yes.
For sure. Like, right now.
Yeah.
Can we please sleep first?
Yeah, I would also like to sleep. Elo would also like to nappy nap.
Head back to the tavern, perhaps?
Actually, Gash is gonna fucking sit down in the middle of this house. She's gonna fucking go to sleep here later. She's gonna stay with the ghost right there? Yeah!
Ghost's a little startled, but she's not gonna, like, move Gash. Gash is fucking huge.
Elo's just gonna, at this point, just go back to the tavern. Solve it tomorrow. My ass is missing. I need that. You can see his legs starting to like flow out. Like
I want Dante to like walk up to him and just pick him up. Come on, you stupid animal.
Yay!
You dumb animal. He says in a very friendly way.
Elo's just like my uncle used to say.
Wow, me too.
Oh, shit.
Wow. So all of you go off to the tavern again?
He gives a wink to the ghost girl before he actually heads out.
She shakes her head. She's like, do you have a piece of paper at all? Maybe I can do something that can help with looking for her if you're going to do that. Which I would be so appreciative of. Obviously, I don't have much of anything to give you after, but, you know.
I have a little notepad in my belongings, and he reaches in
his little satchel and takes out a tiny little ink quill and a little piece of scrumbled up paper, and he gets ready to write down whatever she says.
Okay, so my daughter, blonde curly hair, her name is Priya, she was wearing her sleep clothes, but it's been 100 years, she's probably she's not wearing them anymore. Unless she is, that would be, oh no, never mind. she has a mole on the underside of her jaw, and her eyes are brown. She has brown eyes.
All
How
right,
cute.
I have written this all down. I promise I will return to you and tell you as soon as I possibly can, madame.
Okay. Y'all got a weird group.
Yeah, very aware of that one.
And you're a fucking ghost.
Dante, well, you shut the fuck up.
Oh man, I think I'm gonna need a hug from
go
that.
Go fuck the bed.
I'm gonna go enjoy one of these.
A
bottle of wine.
Sleepover.
Hey, sleepover.
You also want some wine?
You want some wine, Elo? Oh my god. We can share the bottle.
Everyone goes back to the tavern except for Gash, who has immediately fallen asleep on the ground of Dolly's house.
She's so cute.
And Dolly kind of like hangs out with Gash while Gash falls asleep.
Can I make a fucking constitution saving
throw
to stay awake?
I guess, yeah, if you want to.
Why are you like this?
Just for 15 more minutes. Not enough to get another level of exhaustion. I just want to talk to the sleep. I got a 14 and a nat 20.
If you end up staying up all night tonight, you will not take another level of exhaustion.
I'm not staying.
I'm just saying that's what the nat 20 gets you. If you do end up staying up all night, you will not take another level of exhaustion.
I will not take the nat 20 then. Actually, never mind. I don't know if you've noticed, but Gash is having a lot of trouble. She's kind of not doing so good on ability checks and communication right now. But she. Companionship and or comfort, even if she's a freaky 8'10" furball lady. If she could communicate that she knows sort of what the situation is like, she would, but she can't. So she's going to just try her best to provide some sort of companionship or comfort. Aww. By being there.
Here's what I'll say. As everybody else leaves and you kind of stick behind, she looks at you, and then she just kind of, kind of acknowledging that you're not going anywhere, she sits on the very edge of, where her house used to be, overhanging the rest of the fissure. She just kind of sits there, and, you recognizing what it's like to go through something similar to this, you take a seat next to her, and you just kind of sit there for a couple minutes, just silently, but, acknowledging that, you know, shit sucks.
Shit sucks, yeah. Gash kind of wears a lot of shit. You know, the barbarian spikes and some just, I feel like she has some necklaces and shit that are just, common for barbarians, but, she takes this, stone bracelet that's, around her wrist that nobody, I don't know, it's most people are, that's, I don't know, barbarian shit. She just kind of rubs it. Kind of looks out to the crevice and how deep and far it goes, and looks at how big the land is before her, and thinks about how it served as her home for all these years, yet the more she's wandered it essentially all her life, and she never, she wonders if there's any point of, if there's a point she'll reach where she'll be satisfied.
Okay, I guess with that, that's a good way to end it. Everybody goes off drinking.
while Gash and the ghost are having this fucking somber moment, Dante's the bards are fucking playing caramel dancing on their pan flute.
Oh, thank God.
Dante is absolutely caramel dancing.